It's Kirsty Brown.
This is to say, Happy International Women's Day.
Wishing all the ladies a very wonderful, happy International Women's
Day. It's Kerry Katona here. Happy International Women's Day.
Hello, yes, it is me.
Hello guys, girls, non-binary pals. My name is Frida Safik.
Good evening.
It's WWE Hall of Famer Lita.
I'm Dr. Angel Storm. I'm the owner of Manifold Mind Coach.
Hi, I'm Raina Corrigan.
It's Linda Petcher. I'm Ghost.
This is Lisa Marie Varon.
It's Linda Lusardi here.
It's Andrea Patterson here.
My name is Kelly Wild.
It's Lorraine Crosby here, wishing all the women happy International Women's Day.
Cigarettes in an ashtray. My love and I in a small cafe. Then a stranger came along, and everything went wrong. Now there's three cigarettes in the ashtray. I watched her take him from me.
Welcome to this special International Women's Day episode of Dartsman's Key Secret Life. 27th lady, a new face to this year's episode. Well, today is International Women's Day. Imagine a gender equal world, a world free of bias, stereotypes and discrimination. A world that's diverse, equitable and inclusive. A world where difference is valued and celebrated. Together we forge women's equality. Celebrate women's achievements, raise awareness about discrimination, take action to drive gender parity. International Women's Day belongs to everyone, everywhere. Inclusion means all action is valid. We're kicking off the shout-outs this year with Lady 24 and a TNA wrestling superstar, Masha Slamovic.
Hi Diane, this is your favorite, the Russian Dynamite, Masha Slamovic. I just want to wish all the ladies a happy International Women's Day. I'm delighted to return on Dartsman Key Secret Life. Let's push for gender equality and squash discrimination, break down bias. As for me, delivering plenty more SmackDowns here at TNA.
Hello everybody, a big thank you Diane for hosting. Today we're celebrating International Women's Day. We're thinking about the women all around the world who live ordinary and extraordinary lives and how powerful it is when women get together to support each other. But in order to do this, we need to think very, very carefully about how to support the me before we support the we. When women get together, incredible things happen. But in order to do so, we've got to really take care of our mental fitness. So this is my big shout out to all the women of the world. Time to pack your mental fitness kit bag for a really, really strong year. It's possible for all of us, a bit like when we take care of our physical health, to strengthen our mental fitness muscles, to really take care. And that's regular practice, it's simple habits, it's everyday things that we need to pack in our mental fitness kit bag, girls, so that we can have more, be more and do more. So if you need a mental fitness coach, I'm your gal, I'm here to help, get in touch. If you would like a free discovery call so we can think about what needs to happen for you and how you can go forward fearlessly with the confidence to thrive. Happy International Women's Day. Over and out.
Yo, DJ, pump this party.
Wow, it's your time. You know you're gonna be mine. You know you're gonna be mine. You know you're gonna be mine.
Hi, Diane. It's Angie Brown. How are you, ladies? I hope you're having a wonderful International Women's Day. Da 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 da. I know, I sound awful, don't I? Yeah, I haven't warmed up my voice. Anyway, that's by the by. I hope you lovely ladies are having the best time. Take care. Keep up the good work, Diane. Bye. I know it's a good job, but good work. Okay, bye.
Hello
Diane, it's Andrea Colley, wishing all the ladies a happy International Women's Day.
Songs that get louder, each one better than before. And you're singing the songs, thinking this is a life. And you wake up in the morning and your hip is twist the size. Where you gonna go? Where you gonna go? Where you gonna sleep tonight? Where you gonna sleep?
It's Danielle Hayes.
What
pleased to be
part of
International Women's Day. Drink down the pies. Three girls gonna run this something new, something I can hold on to.
Hi Diane, it's Ginny. Just wanted to say happy International Women's Day, celebrating women everywhere. Have a great day.
Friends, I know darn well that I'm headed straight for hell if I keep on living the crazy way I do. To a hillbilly girl, to a hillbilly girl, to a hillbilly girl with the blues.
DJ Shazia, be International Women's Day to the ladies. Let's push for gender equality.
It's murder on the dance floor. But you better not kill the groom, DJ. Gonna burn this goddamn house right down.
Hello everyone, Nicole Faraday here, wishing you a happy International Women's Day, a day where women are recognised for their achievements and we stand together as a united force to advance gender equality throughout the world. I thought you might be interested to see an image that was widely circulated in the 1900s that really demonstrates the history of women's fight for equality. The image here, which was published on a postcard in 1908, was intended by its original publishers in the early 20th century to rubbish the cause of women's suffrage. It shows a cat wearing the suffragette colours of purple, white and green. It was thought that by portraying a campaigner as a cat, it would show that the idea of women voting was equally absurd. The cat was in those days seen as passive, feminine, and ineffectual. This might also have been a reference to the UK's so-called Cat and Mouse Act of 1913, which permitted women suffrage hunger strikers to be released from prison in order to recover before being rearrested so they could continue serving their sentence, likening the legislation to the way that a cat plays with a mouse. Now, some anti-suffrage cartoons portrayed men at home doing household chores with a cat present. This was intended to suggest that the absence of his campaigning wife meant that the poor man was not free to do useful work outside of the house. By the same token, dogs were very often depicted in order to represent men. Both men and dogs were seen as being more physically active. So, did the anti-suffrage advertising work? Well, women in the UK finally gained the right to a vote on the same terms as men over the age of 21 in the 1928 Representation of the People Act. And nowadays, cats are admired by everyone for their strength and resilience. So, looks as though their tactic may have backfired. Bye-bye for now. This cat is signing off.
Thank you, Nicole, for this episode. From me, Diane Heslop, see you all soon.
Happy International Women's Day. Goodbye. She looks great. Thanks for watching. Bye. What a well-dressed pussycat.